Marriage is what brings us together. Marriage, that blessed arrangement, that dream within a dream. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of Maria, Andrew, and their families, I would like to welcome you to celebrate in this couple's dream within a dream in the sacred bond of marriage. Who gives this woman to be married? I do.
Is it because it's small?
Maria and Andrew, marriage is not just the symbol of your love for one another, and to love each other wholeheartedly for all the days of your lives. Marriage isn't some magic ceremony where, like, once completed, all disagreements and fights disappear or cease to exist, like a Cleveland championship. No, there will be disagreements. There will be times you two argue, but the important thing to remember is this. Never go to bed angry. Let your love be stronger than your anger. Let love always win. Always communicate with one another. Share your feelings with each other. Be willing to make sacrifices for each other. And be willing to compromise. Remember, it's always better to bend than it is to break. But most of all, you two, tell each other I love you. I love you. And remember, Andrew, coming from a married man, she's always right. Even if she's wrong, she's right. And look, and don't forget, marriage is a sacred gift, and so it should be treated as such. Just imagine for a minute you get a gift, this gift you've been wanting and dreaming of for so long, and finally you get it. You wouldn't put that gift in the closet, turn the lights off, let it collect dust, throw old books on top of it. No. You would protect that gift. You would hold that gift so tight, you would make sure nobody messed with it. You two are each other's gift. So honor each other, love each other unconditionally, always and forever. At this time, Maria would like to invite her cousin Elenia to read an excerpt from a poet, Khalil Gibran, about marriage.
You were born together, and together you shall be forevermore. You shall be together when the white wings of death scatter your days. You shall be together even in the silent memory of God. But let there be spaces in your togetherness, and let the winds of the heavens dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together and be joyous, but let each one of you be alone, even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping, for only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together, for the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in the shadow.
If anyone here has just cause as to why these two should not be wed, speak now or forever hold your peace. I'm glad we have that. Now we're in Andrews. They have written their own vows, and at this time I'll ask Maria to read the vows that she has prepared for Andrew. All right.
Andrew, I promise to be your lover, companion, teammate, and friend, in plenty and in want, in sickness and in health, in failure and in triumph. I promise to be your partner in parenthood, your ally in conflict, your greatest supporter and your strongest challenger. Your comrade in adventure, your student and your teacher, your anchor in a storm, the sour cream to your pomegranate. This is my sacred vow to you, my equal in all things.
And I'm Andrew.
And I, Maria, promise to be your lover and companion, teammate and friend. In plenty and in want, in sickness and in health, in failure and in triumphs. I promise to be your partner and parent, your ally in conflict, your greatest supporter and your strongest challenger, your comrade in adventure, your student and your teacher, your anchor and storm, the chicken to your waffles. This is my sacred vow to you, my equal in all things.
Maria, do you take Andrew to be your husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only unto him forevermore?
I do.
Andrew, do you take Maria to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore?
I do.
These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end, no giver and no receiver. For each is the giver, and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you of the vows that you have taken. Maria, please take this ring, put it on Andrew's finger, and repeat after me. I, Maria.
I, Maria.
Take thee, Andrew.
Take thee, Andrew.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you as my husband.
I take you as my husband.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Andrew, put this on her finger and look at her. I, Andrew.
I, Andrew.
Take thee, Maria.
Take thee, Maria.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To love and to hold.
To love and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you as my wife.
I take you as my wife.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
So now you two, to make this relationship work, it's going to take love. It is the core of your marriage and the very reason you're standing here today. It will take trust. Trust to know that in your hearts you truly want what's best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow together. And it will take faith. Faith to go forward together, without knowing exactly what the future holds. Commitment. We'll take commitment to hold true to the journey you have both led through today. So without further ado, by the power invested in me by the state of Ohio and Universal Life Monasteries Online, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Thank you. encountered, had an encounter with Andrew. I crushed his 9th birthday party. And you make mistakes as a fetus, but it was a poor first impression. But I often get asked what it's like if it's boring to be an only child, grow up as an only child. And I feel like I'm not very qualified to speak about that. Because when I think about my childhood, I think about waking up many mornings playing Donkey Kong Country, Super Mario Brothers, with Andrew. I bugged him, my little brother would. I always asked him to play. So I can't really speak about what it would be like to be an only child. And even less so when Maria joined the family. She's definitely a sister to me. I'm really proud of Andrew. I don't call you a large talk a lot. I'm not really good about that. But you're on my mind a lot. I've told pretty much all my friends about my uncle who's progressed so far and is getting a degree in accounting. And his really cool fiance, Maria, and their like incredibly cute son. And I'm proud of the father you are. I'm proud of how far you've come. And I'm proud that you're someone that can make someone as wonderful as Maria happy. Great, not done yet. And I'm grateful too, because Maria's amazing and loving and caring. And she's part of the reason that like I can go to bed without worrying about my family. And it wouldn't be the same without her, ever.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Maria Andrew would like to come to you.
still love you the same. Cause honey, your soul could never grow.
My life is yours. I love you. Because I'm not going to